Now that we have the concepts down, let's go through some actual code. You can find a link to the repository that contains this application in the instructor notes. So here we have a pizza ordering application. You can click on this Add Pizza button here to add pizzas, and each pizza has its own unique number. We can also click any of these X buttons to remove the pizzas. And you'll notice that if we add a couple more pizzas, it starts off where we left off, 7, 8. Now let's take a look at the actual code behind this, more specifically, the model that's driving it. Now before we dive into the JavaScript, I'll just mention that we have an HTML file here, and we've also got a style.css file right here. You can go through this code on your own if you'd like to figure out how it works, but it's relatively simple. Just some HTML DOM nodes and some CSS selectors and properties. The JavaScript is where the heart of this application lies. We have var data, and if we scroll down, we also have var octopus and var view. Let's take a look at the model up here. Now in this application, the model is just called data. It doesn't necessarily have to be called model per se, but that's its function. And you can see that our model is just a simple object with a couple properties inside. It's got a property for the last ID of the pizza and an array of pizza objects. With such a simple example, it may not seem obvious why we want to separate this out, but bear with me. Sometimes our model isn't so simple, and we'll see examples of this in the near future.